Morning students, how are you all? Hope you all are doing good. Okay, hope you all are learning your daily lessons also. Very good. Shall we come back to our lesson? In this partnership accounts, we are dealing with the retirement of the partners, all the adjustments regarding the retirement of a partner. There we have completed four adjustments. The fifth one is adjustment of current year's profit or loss. Current year's profit or loss up to the date of retirement will be transferred to the retiring partner's capital account, because if a partner retires in between a year till the date of retirement or death, the partner's share of profit should be transferred to his account. Okay, to his capital account or current account. Understand? So for that we need to make an entry. What is the entry? Because it is profit, one profit and loss suspense account should be prepared. Profit and loss suspense account debtor to retiring partner's capital account or current account. Retiring partner's capital account or current account. If it is fluctuating capital method, capital account. If it is fixed capital method, current account. Okay. Then, if they have got profit, this is the end. Okay. Or if they have incurred loss, the reverse entry will be prepared. Retiring partners, capital or at current account debtor to profit and loss suspense account. Then this suspense account will be closed by transferring this one to the profit and loss account. Okay, so profit and loss account debtor to profit and loss suspense account entry must be made. But that is not asked now for us. Okay, so here we need to calculate the profit. That is the calculation that we have to do. The year's profit, there are written two methods we can calculate, either from the previous year's profit. If it is 36,000, then if he retires at the end of March, then 3 months only we need to prepare. Then if there are three partners, then only one partner share only he will get, isn't it? So, if they share the profit equally, 1 by 3 only we will get. Okay, so that share we need to calculate, then this amount should be transferred to this account. Profit and loss suspense account debtor to retiring partner's capital account. Otherwise, they can calculate the profit from the average profit of previous years. Okay, previous years, maybe 3 years or 4 years will be given. We need to calculate the total, all the years profit divided by number of years. We will get average profit then into, if he retires at the end of 31st March, the 3 months, then if he share the profits and loss equally, 1 by 3. We will get one amount. For that amount, we need to prepare this entry. Profit and loss suspense account debtor to retiring partner's capital or current account. Shall we see one illustration? Justina, Navi and Ritika are partners sharing profits and losses equally. On 31/3/2019, Ritika retired from the partnership firm. Profits of the preceding years is as follows. 2016, 2017, 2018 given. Find out the share of profit of Ritika for the year 2019 till the date of retirement. If A, profit is to be distributed on the basis of the previous year's profit. B, profit is to be distributed on the basis of the average profit of the last 3 years. Also, pass necessary journal entries by assuming that partners' capitals are fluctuating. So, we need to transfer to fluctuate that to capital accounts. Now, first we need to calculate the share of profit. Okay. A, if profit is to be distributed on the basis of the previous year's profit. C, previous year's profit 30,000, then for 3 months, 3 by 12, into equally they share, so 1 by 3, we will get 2,500. For that, we need to make the entry. Profit and loss suspense account data to Ritika's capital account. Then Ritika's current year share of profit credited to her capital account. Okay, then B, if profit is to be distributed on the basis of the average profit of the past 3 years. 3 years profit given 5,000, 10,000, 30,000. So, how much? 45,000 divided by 3, we will get 15,000. That one, his share, we need to calculate her share, Ritika's share. 15,000 into 3 by 12 into 1 by 3, 1,250. Then we need to make the entry. Profit and loss suspense account data to Ritika's capital account. Ritika's current year share of profit credited to her capital account. Okay, shall we do the exercise? Okay, 14th exercise we will do. Okay, you please take your textbook and notebook also. Okay, notebook, and just listen and you can copy down later. Okay, let me read out the problem for you. When I read, you also keep the textbook and follow me. Rani, Jaya and Rati are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 2:2:1. On 31-3-2018, Rati retired from the partnership firm. Profit of the preceding years is as follows: 14, 15, 16 and 17. Find out the share of profit of Rati for the year 2018 till the date of retirement if profit is to be distributed on the basis of the previous year's profit. B, profit is to be distributed on the basis of the average profit of the past 4 years. Okay, shall we do this one in the notebook? Okay, number 14. First, we need to calculate. Okay, A, we will write. Profit is to be distributed on the basis of the A, we have to write fully on the basis of the previous year's profit. Okay. Share of profit of Rati. The previous years, isn't it? Previous years means 2017. 17, 30, 2000. Then, how many months he retires? She retires on 31-3, so 3 months. Then, profit sharing ratio 2 by 5. Okay. Radhi's share. Radhi only retires 1 by 5. Okay. 12, 4 we can give, isn't it? Or 3, 1, 4. Then this 4 and this 1. 8 fours are 32. Then 5. 1, 5 is 5. Balance 3, 36. So 1,600. Okay, now we need to prepare the journal entry. We have to draw the column. Okay, I am not writing, drawing the column. First write the date. When 31st March 2018. Okay, what entry we need to make? Profit and loss. Suspense account data. To Radhi's capital account. Why capital account? Because they follow the fluctuating capital method. Okay, that is share of profit. Credited to her account. Okay, 1600. Okay, then B. B, profit is to be distributed on the basis of average profit of the past 4 years. First, we will calculate the average profit. What are the year's profit? 10,000, 14th year, then 15th year 20,000 plus 18,000 plus 32,000 divided by 4. How much? 32, 40, 50, 70, 80. 80,000 divided by 4, 20,000. Okay, average profit we have calculated. Now, that is share of profit. So, average profit 20,000 into for 3 months 3 by 12 into her share 1 by 5. Okay, here 12, 3, 4. Then 4, 5,000. Okay. Then 5, this 5. So 1,000. Okay. Now we need to make the journal entry. Journal entry, we should draw 5 lines. Okay. I am writing the date. What is the date? 2018 March 31. Profit and loss suspense account data are same entry only. All simple, easy problems only, but you may not confuse. Okay, what is the problem you should, when you read that, you should understand. For that, you should remember. May not forget. Okay. So if you remember this one, you can do to Radhi's capital account. We are distributing the profit, so profit and loss suspense account must be debited. We are transferring that one to the retiring partner's capital account. Radhi's share of profit. Credited to her capital account, amount 1,000. Now we will see the next adjustment. Okay, the last adjustment, settlement of the amount, the last one, settlement of the amount due to the retiring partner. Here the all the capital accounts of the retiring partner, all the adjustments that we have made, isn't it, at the time of retirement. What is the first one? That transfer of accumulated profits and reserves. That one, then revaluation profit will be transferred, then share of any profit or remuneration, everything, or this the share of profit, all these will be entered in the retiring partner's capital account. That amount must be settled. That is the amount due to the retiring partner. This can be settled either by paying cash immediately, or if they do not pay the cash immediately, they will transfer that amount to the retiring partner's loan account, or they will do partly cash and partly it will be transferred to the loan account. Okay, part payment, paying part. Okay, partly payment, either partly cash and partly transfer to the loan account. What will be the journal entry? Here, retiring partner's capital account debtor if they pay in cash, retiring partner's capital account debtor to cash or bank if they pay through bank check. Okay. Or if they pay, if they transfer, if they do not make payment immediately, they will transfer that account to the loan account. So what is the entry? Retiring partner's capital account debtor to retiring partner's loan account. Okay, if they make payment both, that means partly cash and partly transferring to loan account, joining entry. Okay, third one, what will be the journal entry? Retiring partner's capital account debtor to cash account to retiring partner's loan account. Okay, so then this one, okay, joining these two. Then this loan account, if you do not pay, this loan will be shown in the liability side. Other partner's capital account will be also on the liability side as capital, but this one will be shown as the loan in the liabilities side. Okay, now we will see one illustration. Kavita, Kumuda and Lalita are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 5:3:3. Respectively, Kumuda retires from the firm on 31st December 2018. On the date of retirement, her capital account shows a credit balance of 2 lakhs. Past journal entries. Okay, so who is retiring? Kumuda, her account shows 2 lakh balance. So the amount due is paid off immediately by check. So bank. Okay, what will be the entry? Kumuda's capital account debtor to bank, amount due paid immediately, 2 lakh. Okay, then second one, amount due is not paid immediately. So, Kumuda's capital account debtor to Kumuda's loan account, amount due transferred to loan account, 2 lakh. Then third one, 70,000 paid immediately by check. So, Kumuda's capital account debtor to bank to Kumuda's loan account, 70,000 bank, remaining 1,30,000 loan account. Okay, 70,000 paid and the balance transferred to loan account. Okay, shall we do this pattern of exercise? Settlement of amount due to the retiring partner, the 15th exercise. Okay. Kavin, Madan and Ranjit are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 4:3:3 respectively. Kavin retires from the firm on 31st December 2018. On the date of retirement, his capital account shows a credit balance of 1,50,000. First journal entry is if the amount due is paid off immediately. Amount due is not paid immediately, 1 lakh is paid and the balance in future. Okay, so 3 journal entries we need to prepare. That's all. Okay. Number 15. First journal entry. A. The amount due is paid off immediately. For the problem, you have to write number A because the past journal entry is if A is given. So write that one A. The amount due is paid off immediately. What will be the journal entry? Okay, retiring partner Kavin. So Kavin's capital account debtor. To that cash, isn't it? You write cash because it is not given, it is paid through bank or check to cash account. Current account. Is settled, is paid off immediately. How much? 1,50,000. Then second one, B. The amount due is not paid immediately. Okay, rightfully. Then same, Kavin's capital account debtor to Kavin's loan account. We should write the name. Okay, Kavin's loan account. Amount due is not paid immediately. $1,50,000. Then C, write the heading. Okay, 1 lakh is paid and the balance in future. So entry, Kavin's capital account debtor to cash to Kavin's loan account. Total 1,50,000. How much is paid in cash? 1 lakh. Then 50,000. Okay, then you can write amount 1 lakh is paid and the balance paid in future. Will be paid in future. Okay. Settlement. Then the next problem also we will do. Okay, exercise. See, Manju, Charu and Lavanya are partners in a firm sharing profits and loss in the ratio of 5:3:2. Their balance sheet shows capital, creditors, profit and loss account, building, furniture, stock, debtors, cash in hand. Manju retired on 31/3/2018, subject to the following adjustments: stock depreciated, provision created, building appreciated. Prepare revaluation account and capital account. Okay, so we will prepare the revaluation account. First, revaluation account. only the profit and loss items must be taken. Okay, stock depreciated, so to, you should draw line. Okay, to stock 10,000. Provision for doubtful debts, it is also loss. Provision for doubtful debts, rightfully, okay, 3,000. Buildings appreciated by, so by buildings 28,000. Now we need to balance the account. Okay, 28,000 here, 28,000. So here how much we will get to? So totally when we should transfer this profit on revaluation, transfer to partner's capital, Manju, Charu, Lavanya. Okay, we have to calculate the amount. Okay, here I have to do the capital account, so here I am doing the calculation. Okay, but you have to do under the problem, down the page only. Okay, that 15,000 into ratio 5/10. So 1,500 into 5, 7,500. Then next person 3, 4,500. Next one 2, 3,000. Okay, now capital accounts. 3 amount column, isn't it? Manju, Charu, Lavanya. Okay, opening balance you will write by balance brought down 70,000, 70,000, 70,000. Now this profit by profit on revaluation account. Revaluation account is 7,500. 4,500, 3,000. Now in the balance sheet, one profit and loss account is there. So that must be transferred. Okay, the first adjustment by profit and loss account. 50,000. Okay, 50,000 into 5/10. So 25. Okay. So 25,000, then 3, 15,000, 2, 10,000. Okay, any other thing in the balance sheet? No, we have transferred. Okay, now we have transferred everything, we will add and find out the amount. 005 12, 2, balance 1, 10. 7, 2, 0, 5, 9, 8. 0, 0, 0, 3, 8. Okay, so we should write that one as to balance carried on. No item on the debit side. Full amount will be the balance. 1,02,500. 89,500, 83,000. Then write the same amount straight to that total amount. Okay, 1,02,500, 89,500, 83,000. Then by balance brought down. $1,2,500, $89,583,000. Okay, the problem. Okay, we will do the comprehensive problems. That means with almost all the adjustments, we will do the problems tomorrow. So by tomorrow, we can complete this chapter. Okay, the day after tomorrow, I will teach you another next chapter. Okay, students, thank you very much.